Hey Nesters, welcome back to the channel. Today I am going to share with you a yard sale haul. But before I share the haul, I am going to take you along with me as I went to this yard sale so you can see what it was like, and then I'll meet you back here in a minute.
Hello.
Good, have a good day. We can mean that right now. Books are 10 cents a piece.
Okay.
Anything on this table is a quarter.
All right.
The lamps are a quarter. We've got a Thanksgiving setting, 12 pieces. That's from the Johnson brand, and they're pretty dear. They're $100.
Okay.
Yeah, people used to do that, but not much anymore.
Right. They're pretty.
People aren't in the doodads no more, and they're not in the dishware no more.
No.
Yeah, the books are 10 cents a piece, and those are a quarter a piece, the holy books.
Okay.
Okay?
Yep, sounds right. Good. Kind of scratched up though. I don't know. 1987 Hallmark. Kind of cute. Like Oatgary or whatever they call it.
You've been out and about today?
Yeah, we went over to the ones in the Brewer Gettysburg neighborhood or whatever. It's quite busy over there.
Yeah. We, yesterday morning, I didn't open, but they came at 6:30, five cars and trucks.
Oh, yeah.
And they were the professionals. And they wiped us out of the good stuff.
Yeah.
But I tell you, they, if it was a 25-cent piece, they quibbled over the price, let alone the good stuff that we had. But that's their livelihood.
Yeah.
The weather might be changing on us.
Yeah, it looks like the rain's gonna come soon. At least I held off for most of the day.
Yeah. Yesterday morning I was out here at 4:30 and I got a wet butt. I'm having lunch. I'm going to go pop back in.
Okay.
Except for the bike and the freezer and the Thanksgiving thing. Take what you want. I don't know nothing.
You just want me to take it?
Yes.
Are you sure?
If you have an interest, yes.
Okay.
got some bags, paper bags there. I mean, plastic bags. And I got no wrapping paper here.
Okay. All right. Thank you. Have a good day. Enjoy your lunch. Noritake. This is like a set here. What is this? Little appetizer forks, I guess. Thank you. Kind of cool. Kind of cute. Nitto Heather Stone.
So as you guys can see, that yard sale was kind of interesting. As I walked up, he told me the prices of everything. They were very inexpensive, other than he had this fancy Thanksgiving dinnerware set that he wanted like $100 for. And then as I was looking around, he was saying, actually, I'm in the process of making my lunch, so, you know, just take what you want. I didn't see anything. And I was like, what does that mean? And I was like, you sure you want me to just take it? And he said, yep, just take it. And he handed me a tote. So I took some stuff, and then he came back out, and I ended up giving him $7 because I kind of just was trying to remember the prices he had told me, and he luckily took it. I just felt weird just taking his stuff after he gave me prices. I know he had the yard sale the day before, so he probably was just going to throw it beside the road pretty soon anyways, but I felt like giving him some money for it, so I did very well for $7, I think, anyways. So I will start with the items that I will be listing in my Etsy shop. Most of this stuff should be listed when this video goes live. If not, check back in a couple days if you see anything you're interested in, and it'll probably be up there. And the first thing I saw was this really interesting container here. It has this really gorgeous floral on the outside. It's in this beautiful ivory color. And I believe this was made in Hong Kong. Now, what's inside of it is very interesting. I don't know if you guys ever seen one of these before, but it's filled with these little teeny forks here for little snacks or appetizers. There's quite a few of them inside, and I thought this was adorable. I really think that's quite fancy and nice. I really like that. So I was happy to pick that up, and I do plan to list this on Etsy, like I said. I think I'm going to ask about $25 to $28 and include shipping in that. So it'll be free shipping on the site. And yeah, so I thought that was fun. He had a few different types of mugs there that I was looking through. And I thought this one was kind of nice. It has this gorgeous rainbow coloring around it. And this is a vintage Hallmark put out in 1987. And it has this cute little quote, life lessons quote. And it's put out by Linda Lee Elrod. I believe she made a few other, well, Hallmark made a few other types of mugs with her poems or quotes on it. This one says, "When life gets a little rocky, please remember, without the rain, there would be no rainbows. Without the winter, there would be no spring. Every trial carries within it the potential for triumph, waiting to be brought forth by you." So that's really cute. And you can see it's Hallmark down here on the bottom. So it's in excellent shape. I don't really have to do too much to it. So I'm happy with that. That's kind of a tough sale for me. If I see a nice mug and then it has all those fork or scratch marks in the bottom and just looks like it's too much effort for, you know, the price you can get for them. So yeah, it's in pretty good shape. And I think I'm going to ask about $22, and that's the price when it's shipped. So yeah, I think that will do pretty well. Another mug I decided to get is this one here with the duck on it. I believe it's Otagiri. It's not marked, but I mean, it looks like Otagiri, right? So it has this brown speckling, like, you know, is typical, and the graphic is very similar, as well as the handle having the brown on it. So I'm pretty sure that's what it is. Now, I think I'm gonna ask just slightly a bit more for this. I think I'll probably go for about 23, 24. With shipping included, so we'll give it a shot at that price. I really like this. I was kind of tempted to keep this, but I don't need any more mugs, so hopefully someone can enjoy this. So we had this little stack of older tea saucer style plates, and I kind of glanced through them. I grabbed a couple to keep for myself. I'm just gonna use them underneath my planters to, you know, allow the water to drain through without getting my shells all wet. And so the first one I got was this one here with the really pretty blue flowers on it. I like that this one was lipped, you know, to help keep the water in a little bit better if it's draining out too much. This one was put out by Lenore. It's called Spring Melody, and it's fine china, Sloan China Company, made in USA. So if you guys like that pattern, then yeah, I think that's really pretty. Be interested to come across some of that in the future. And this one I also really liked with the, I believe it's roses on it. That one's obviously a saucer. It has the little circle in the center for a cup. And I really love the florals on that one. I don't know what ever happened to the little teacups that should have went with it, but this one is rosebud pattern put out by Shelley in England. So that's what that one is. That one's gorgeous. I really like that. It has the green around the edging. So I got those two for me to use under plants. So we had a couple different types of Corelle fruit dessert bowls, and there was a set of four of this pattern here. This pattern's called Jasmine, and it's in this nice, I guess, periwinkle blue, I would call it. And I really like this size bowl. It's perfect for if you just want some berries, or, you know, just a little snack. It's really, really is the quite the nice size. And so replacements.com has these listed for $9.99 a piece. And, you know, that doesn't include shipping. But I'm going to list this set of four for $25 and include free shipping. I think they're really nice, and I do think that's a really gorgeous pattern on it. So I think someone's going to enjoy those. So we only had two of these style bowls here with the blue and yellow stripes around it. I'm a little bit confused by what this pattern is exactly. It looks like Cassiflora, right? Because Cassiflora is the same colors, only the yellow is switched with the blue. So you'd have the yellow first and then the blue. And also in the Cassifloras, there is like a darker navy one on the inside here. So I don't think they're Cassiflora, though they would pair well with that set. I think what they are actually is Haley, and I'm not certain, but I think that's what they are. Now, where there's only two of them, it's really not worth my time to list, because, you know, the price that I would think was fair to list these two bowls for wouldn't be worth my time by the time, you know, I shipped it and did all that. So I'm gonna hang on to them. If I come across a couple more, I'll probably list them, but if not, I'll probably just throw them in my antique booth. But yeah, I think that's a really nice bowl to use anyways, and I'm sure someone will enjoy it. So I also grabbed the set of four plates here. They are lipped around the edge, so I assume they're for salad. And they're really stunning. I love the floral detailing on it. They are put out by Nitto, their Heatherstone, in the Kaiku or Kiku pattern. And yeah, Japan. So I couldn't find any comps on these. I looked on replacements.com and they had one listed, as in they had a picture of it, but it was out of stock. So what that tells me is these are hard to find. So I think listing these for $35 to $40 and include free shipping in that is a fair price, and we'll see how they do. But, you know, if someone is on the hunt for this pattern, I think they're going to be pretty happy that I listed them. So I was happy to rescue those from likely the curbside, and yeah, got those. So those are fun. So also sitting on the table, he had this set of two Pfaltzgraff bowls, and I actually have someone that bought a trivet off of me that said that her grandmother, I believe, used to have this set, and she really wanted that trivet because she's trying to collect it as well, you know, over again. And so she might be interested in this. I'm going to contact her and see if she wants it first. But yeah, I saw this on the table. I actually think what it is, I think this is a soup bowl, and then I'm guessing this is probably some type of a salad bowl maybe, but it's clearly has been used for a chip and dip bowl, which look at that. I mean, you can't beat that. That's definitely a chip and dip bowl. So that's what I'll list it for. And like I said, this is Pfaltzgraff. It is gourmet brown pattern, also known as brown drip sometimes. You guys can see why they would call it brown drip, right? But yeah, it's called gourmet brown, and I think I'm going to ask, I think about $40 and include free shipping in that. I think that's pretty fair. It does have some silverware scratch marks on the inside of both of them. It's not too bad. I'm gonna try some Borrower's Keeper friend on that and see if I can get them a little better, but yeah, I think that's a pretty fair price, and we'll see how it does. The next thing I picked up was this random size set of Noritake equator patterned dishes. And I have two bowls here, seven plates, five mugs, a creamer, and a salt shaker. So some of the plates do have some fork scratch marks on them, and they're tan, so they're pretty obvious. You're gonna like kind of see them, but for being tan, they're really not too bad. But like I said, with the other one, I am gonna try to clean those up before I list them. Now, these plates are super heavy, and I normally just offer free shipping because it's built in, so I do, you know, disclaim that shipping is included in my listing in the price, so people know what the price is up front. But this set here of plates, when I list them, I'm actually going to make the buyer pay shipping, because when I went to do my normal gig, you know, I measure them, I weigh them, and then I type in a couple different zip codes just to see what the ballpark shipping would be, so I don't get gypped and, you know, they don't get overcharged and stuff. So this is all over the place because it's so heavy. So I put in California. This to ship to California was, I think it was something like $43. Yeah. And then I want to say I put in Ohio and it was more like $30. So where it was like $18 difference, I didn't feel comfortable including shipping, you know, based on where it went. I didn't want someone that was more local to me to have to pay up for it, and then, you know, if I put it too low, I would lose out on money. So I will make buyer pay shipping on this. Now, these go for a decent amount of money, and these were actually put out for 10 years from 1972 to 1982 is when they were discontinued. And like I said, they do go for fairly good money, so I will list them, oh, probably for $45, and then, like I said, buyer's gonna have to pay shipping. So if you want these, they're probably gonna be at the very least, $25 shipping. I'm not sure where you're gonna be living. So with the rest of the Noritake items, I am just gonna do my normal gig and include the free shipping, build the shipping end to the price. Because they're, you know, much lighter items, they're all gonna be roughly the same price. So not that bad. I got these two bowls here, and these will be all be listed kind of separately because they're just so random. I figured most people that buy these would probably just be looking for replacements, so I just decided to do it that way. Now, these are two cereal style bowls. I believe they call them coupe bowls, and replacements.com has these listed for $21.99 a piece. I think that's a little high myself, but I think I can get the job done for $30 and include free shipping in that. Again, they're on the little bit of a heavier side, but I think they'll be a fair price all around, and apparently they're well sought after. So yeah, we'll see how they do at that price. So also in that set, I picked up five coffee mugs. They are a little bit on the smaller side for coffee mugs, but it gets the job done, especially if you like your coffee black because you don't need the extra room for milk. And yeah, I think they're really nice. I can picture someone having this set in a log cabin or something like that. I think it'd be really cute. And they're really that nice stoneware, so a little bit harder to break, I think. So very nice. They are actually folk stone. And yeah, so super nice. I think I'm going to list those for about 35, maybe 40, and include free shipping. We'll see how that does. And then I have two more items that are kind of random, and I didn't quite know what to do. I didn't want to list them separately because it wouldn't be worth my time. I wouldn't really make much money, you know, doing that that way, you know, based on the price that people would be willing to pay for it. So I've decided to list them together. It's kind of random, but if someone, like I said, is trying to find pieces for this particular equator set, they'll be happy to get these, I think. So he had one random salt shaker and a creamer. So I will list those together. I'll probably only ask about, I don't know, maybe 20 to 25 at the most. Include free shipping in those, and yeah, they're just kind of random, but I mean, I didn't really know what to do with them. I thought about putting this with the coffee cups, but then I just have to list the salt shaker by itself, and I don't know. If you guys think I should list it a different way, let me know below, but sorry, my dog wanted to come in. So if you guys know a different way that I should list these, let me know in the comments below. I needed to break it up just because of the weight of them. And I mean, the plates alone were gonna be pretty expensive, right? So I don't think anyone's gonna want to pay that crazy of shipping. It'd probably be like $100 if I put it all together. So yeah, we'll see how they do anyways. And maybe someone just needs some replacements, and hopefully I did a good thing in getting them for them and listing them. So when I went into the yard sale, he told me the lamps were gonna be 25 cents, but they were part of his free throw it in the box deal. But I got a couple anyways. Like I said, I paid $7. So I didn't feel bad taking a couple of them. This one I thought was really pretty. I know there's a lot of milk glass haters out there, and then there's a lot of people that still enjoy milk glass. So I got this for the people who enjoy the milk glass, right? And I'm kind of somewhere in between. I really appreciate it and like it. I have several pieces in my own collection, but I am in the process of getting rid of it because I actually prefer color. So I'm going to transition all to color glass and get rid of my milk glass, but I feel like it looks really nice, and people that like to decorate the house in neutral colors, farmhouse and whatnot. So I think someone would really like this, and I really thought it was gorgeous, really. Now the brass on it is, you know, kind of tarnished a little bit in spots, a little, I guess, rust. I'm not really sure what that is. I think it's just tarnished. And it's kind of interesting because it's a two-toned. And at first I thought they had painted this, but I think it was just made that way. And actually kind of looks cool, I think, with it two-toned like that. So I'm not really a huge fan of the super shiny brass, but I like how that looks. So it's kind of a cool combination. Has this nice hurricane glass base on the top here. And I want to call this hobnail, but I don't think this is technically called hobnail. It's almost like a pillowed effect to it, almost like bubble wrap. Take a close up, and maybe you guys know what it's actually called here. If you guys do know the style it's called, let me know, please. Otherwise, I'm probably just going to say it's hobnail. But I thought this was really gorgeous, and this lamp, I looked up some comps because I'm not super familiar with lamps and how much they sell for. I saw a couple very similar to this sell. One sold for $37 shipped, and another sold for $65 shipped. So I think that's a pretty good ballpark range for me. I can figure out what to do here with it. It does need to be rewired. It has this really, that baby is dated. That is a interesting little prong, but it needs to be rewired. If I do the rewiring myself, I'll probably obviously charge a little bit more. So depends on my time. I might rewire it, I might not. But if I can get $65 out of it rewired, I probably would do that. So I might do it. Anyways, I thought that was a really nice lamp, and I think any milk glass lover is going to enjoy this. So I was happy to pick it up and rescue it. And like I said, it was likely going out on the curb, so I think it was definitely worth saving. The other lamp I picked up is this one here. I liked it. It's definitely a modern type of lamp. I don't have to change out the cord on this one. And it's not very heavy at all. I don't know. I obviously can't put it on Etsy because it's too new for that. And I think I probably am just going to put it in my antique booth. I really liked it because it has this kind of French wording and French styled lampshade. I just thought it was really nice. And even the base of it is kind of got a little bit of a neat detailing to it. So I really think it would look nice in several different style homes, probably more so in a bedroom. But yeah, I thought it was really nice. And yeah, well, I don't know what I would charge for it. In my booth, probably, we'll say 18 to 20 maybe. I think it's in great shape, so I think it's worth $20. So the last item I picked up at his yard sale was this beautiful painting. And this in particular was something that I really felt like, hey, I need to give this guy some money because this is gorgeous and I did not feel right taking this for free. So even though he wanted to give it to me, I did not take it. And so I did pay him technically, I guess, $7 for this, or at least $5 and probably $2 for the rest of it. I'm gonna try to get it in the shot here. It's quite large. And it clearly looks like a landscape from Maine, the state I live in. It's absolutely gorgeous. I'm gonna put it back now. This is uncomfortable. But it's absolutely gorgeous. And I'm just gonna keep this for myself, but I really enjoyed that. It's a gorgeous, it has actually a painting. It's not a print. So yeah, that's really nice. I did get one other thing. I'll show you guys. Okay, so I almost forgot about this. I had stopped filming and he had given me a tote, so I was putting all these heavy dishes into it, and then he brought this box of shells over to me. He said, hey, do you want these shells? And I just said yes, because I mean, I didn't technically, it's not something I would have normally grabbed, but you know, I was already taking quite a bit of items and I knew he was trying to get rid of stuff, so why not? I don't know if this is something you can resell on Etsy. I don't decorate with nautical decor in my home, so I don't really have a use for it. I could throw it in the booth, but I mean, there's quite a bit of this kind of stuff around here, so I don't really know that people buy it. But if you guys know if I can sell this on Etsy, maybe for crafting, perhaps, let me know. Yeah. So anyway, the guy was telling me that he handpicked these on a beach in Connecticut, and he was talking about how relaxing and therapeutic it is. And he's right. We enjoy doing that on our oceanside beaches here in Maine. In the summertime, I like looking for the sea glass more so than the shells and interesting rocks. But yeah, these are really cool. There's some interesting ones in here. This one's kind of neat. And then there's this thing. I'm not really sure what that is. Is that some type of a coral? I'm not really sure. Is that coral? And then the ones we find on the beach here in Maine a lot kind of look like this. They're dark and gray, but they kind of look like that one. And then this style here, also usually dark and gray. But these have more of a white color and lightness than the ones I typically find here. Maybe is why I don't really go shelling. Ours aren't too pretty here in Maine that I've ever found, but we do have nice sea glass. And yeah, so I got some interesting ones here. Not sure what I'm gonna do with them yet. If you guys are interested in seashell items, actually, Dizzy Angie is a channel here on YouTube. She does thrifting as well, and she also does shelling on her channel. So if that interests you, go check her out. I will link her below. But yeah, other than that, that's gonna do it for today's yard sale haul. And if you guys wanna see tomorrow's yard sale haul and shop along with me, make sure you're subscribed, hit that thumbs up on your way out if you enjoyed this video, and we'll catch you in the next one. Bye.